Program's going well. We're always trying to grow it. We did have a hiccup this year where we were only able to teach 1,100 kids because one of our main pools was down. And once they go down, it's hard to bring them back up with the cost and working with the municipality. So that was a challenge and an unfortunate one for us. But we're still trying to find other options and find ways to get kids in the water.
And the program runs largely on donations. How can people help if they want to contribute to the program?
They can go to our website. We're out of the Y downtown here, the Bull Family YMCA, Detroit Swims. If you Google it, it'll come right up and you can donate through that. So that's the easy way. If you're not comfortable donating it online, you can send a check to the Y there.
And money donations is the biggest thing you still need, not like swimsuits or goggles or anything
like
that.
We'll take it all. we like to give kids the best equipment that we can come up with, and that's kind of gently used equipment, goggles, caps, swimsuits, so they can learn how to swim and then take the equipment so they can come here to the beach and swim. Mm-hmm.
And let's talk about that. What do you think about bringing the program to, to the beach?
I think it's great. In fact, today I'd rather be on the beach, but, there's so many opportunities for kids in Michigan and Detroit area to come here and enjoy the water that we have. Sometimes pools do go down or you don't have access to a pool. Mm-hmm. This is just as good to cool off on a hot summer day. So we like kids to get comfortable in the natural waters as well.
Mm-hmm. And it kind of maybe reminds kids who live in the city who don't have the same access to water that it's right here. I mean, it's just a short drive away.
Right, and the park's beautiful. You can come out here and just go to the beach. I think a lot of people forget about it.
And why are you involved?
So for me, I saw the need growing up swimming and not really thinking about others who might not have the opportunity. The statistics are very real, especially with kids in the city. 7 out of 10 don't know how to swim. So when I heard that, I thought there's something I have to do to get involved. And I just want to make sure everyone has the opportunity to learn how. You don't have to go to the Olympics and you don't have to be a professional swimmer. But you should be able to enjoy just going to the pool or going to the beach, and I think that's a right everyone should have.
And how do you feel about the impact it's had over the last 4 years?
We've taught, I think, over 6,000 kids how to swim in the city since 2010 when the program first started. So that's a great accomplishment, but we're looking to increase that every day.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you could have gone anywhere. You've been around the world, you've traveled everywhere, you've competed internationally. Why come back to Detroit and make this your home?
Well, this is home for me. A lot of my family's here and friends, and it's a place I'm comfortable with, and I love the area growing up here. So, I think there's a lot of opportunity here, and certainly on the Detroit swim side, there's a great need, because so many kids don't have those skills, and it's like riding a bike, once you learn once, you're good for the rest of your life, and it's a generational issue. If your parents can't teach you, you're not going to be able to teach your kids. So we're trying to break that cycle.
Mm-hmm. Sounds like you're well on your way.
Hopefully. We're hoping every day we can teach all the kids. Mm-hmm.